Ever tried running an executable file in PowerShell and got stuck? Whether you're automating tasks or troubleshooting errors, knowing how to run EXE files with parameters in PowerShell can save you time and effort. In this tutorial, we'll cover multiple ways to do just that step by step. Before we dive into the details, here's a quick overview of the methods we'll cover today. First, we'll use the call operator represented by an ampersand, which is the simplest way to run an EXE file with parameters. Next, we'll explore the start process command, which gives us more control, such as running the process in the background or waiting for it to complete. Finally, we'll look at Invoke-Expression, a powerful way to execute dynamic commands stored as strings. Now, let's go through each method in detail. The first method is the call operator represented by an ampersand symbol. This method is straightforward. Simply type an ampersand followed by the path to the EXE file and then pass any required parameters. For example, let's say we want to run an application located in the program files folder. We use this command. If the file path contains spaces, always enclose it in double quotes to avoid errors. Next, let's explore the start process command. This method allows for more control over execution. To use it, type start process followed by the path to the EXE file. Then pass parameters using the argument list option. Unlike the call operator, start process allows us to specify additional options. For example, we can keep the process in the same window using no new window or wait for it to finish before continuing by adding the wait parameter. Now let's look at invoke expression, a method for running commands stored as strings. This is especially useful when dealing with dynamic input or executing commands from a variable. First, store the command as a string in a variable. Then pass it to invoke expression to execute it. This method is particularly useful for scripting scenarios where commands are generated dynamically. If you run into errors, check the following. 1. Make sure the file path is correct and enclosed in double quotes if it contains spaces. 2. Verify that PowerShell has permission to run the EXE file. If necessary, run PowerShell as an administrator. 3. Ensure that parameters are correctly formatted. Some applications require parameters enclosed in double quotes. For example, if a parameter contains spaces, write it using double quotes around the parameter itself. To quickly recap, use the ampersand operator for simple execution. Use start process when you need more control, such as running in the background or waiting for completion. Use invoke expression when executing commands stored as strings. Each method has its own advantages, so choose the one that best fits your needs. If you found this tutorial helpful, hit the like button, share it with others, and subscribe for more PowerShell tips and tricks.